So Jeff,
Joe get you drunk.
So Jeff,
you
what?
Like, you like Samuel Jackson? I'll get you drunk.
How did the Mayweathers get into boxing? Because without the Mayweathers, it wouldn't be the same. Boxing would not be the same if there was no Mayweather family.
Started boxing, and I think it was one of those things where I know myself, I follow Roger, so I'm assuming that Roger followed Floyd, and little Floyd, he had no choice. He was born to fight. His dad wasn't going to have it no other way. So I know that's how, pretty much how it happened.
The best sense of humor in the family, because everybody's very creative in their humor. Roger, Floyd Senior, you?
I think because I'm quick-witted, so I'm always thinking.
But you're not only a trainer and a former fighter, you're also someone who loves the sport and follows it. That's why when Frank Stea, ATG Radio, does his challenges, you're the undisputed champion of boxing trivia. How do you like that title?
I like it. But I get lucky sometimes.
So Roger never tells you don't know anything about boxing?
He can't tell me, because I can go over there and pick out people he don't know. So
Roger can be stumped. Roger, you tried? Oh, I stumped him before. He plays it off.
He can be stumped, but see, the only thing about it is that the questions that he asks you are only his questions. So he can easily stump you, but if you allow him to ask him questions, he won't know the answers either.
Hundreds of thousands, millions of people train in boxing, get into boxing, have been in boxing. How is it that everyone in your family elevated themselves to such a high level? All three of you, Roger, and Floyd Sr.
Well, I mean, I'm going to be honest, I don't know. I mean, I guess we're just blessed in that aspect, because there's no way of never knowing if, you know, I mean, maybe being students of the game probably helped, but, people say boxing's in your blood, but I don't necessarily believe that, boxing's in your blood. I believe that, it's something that you study just like anything else in school. And, I guess I have been a student of boxing, and I've been around it so long that I picked up a lot, and of course, Roger is, I think, even more so than Bigfoot. Bigfoot, a guy that loved boxing to no end. Like I always tell this story about when he first kind of like started boxing. He was so in love with boxing that the neighbor's dog had bit my sister. And he went over there, and punched the dog in the mouth. I'm a kid, so, at that time I didn't understand it. But now when I look back, that's crazy. That's how in love he was with boxing. So, he had that same kind of, but then Roger was driven by boxing too the same way. Because I remember one day he was at home, I guess he was doing the 76 Olympics with, the Olympics with Leonard, Howard Davis, and things like that. And I never forget, sitting there watching, Roger said, when Howard Davis was fighting, said, I'm with him. Me myself, I'm like, yeah, right. But, not to say that he could have or couldn't have, but, one thing is the fact that Roger became multiple world champion. Howard Davis never became a world champion at all, in the professional ranks, professional level. So, not to say that, what he said is justified, but what it does say is that, he knew in his mind that, he had a lot of will and determination, and of course, he had tremendous belief in himself, and he did become a world champion more than once.
And now Davis' son is a fighter. Davis has a son who's fighting professionally.
Oh, yeah.
He's a good kid.
His son really hasn't had no experience or anything, so...
You're right. He started late.
Yeah, he started late. It was one of those things that when it happens like that, it's kind of like a son stepping in to take the fame that his dad left here for him to take, as opposed to somebody that grows up and creates, you know, they've been, they're raised doing boxing. It's totally different when you're doing it that way. It's almost like, you know, I mean, fortunately, like for Leila Ali, you know, she was able to step in, but she put in the work. You know, I mean, she put in the work. Plus, women's boxing is a lot different than men's boxing. It ain't just, it's not the same. Women's boxing, you can have women that's been boxing for 10 years and still really can't fight. You know, and then you have a woman like Layla that, you know, was, you know, pretty much proud of her father's name, and she wasn't going to shame her father. So she put in the work. Now that she put in the work, you know, then her husband found her the right trainers to make her excel to that level. And, you know, and basically the rest is history for her.
There you have it, Jeff Mayweather, right here at the Mayweather Boxing Club. BSReporting.com. I'm Lee Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak.